Ever wonder how to set up FTP and whether it's really as complicated as people make it out to be? Well, guess what? I'm going to show you just how easy it is, and I'm going to show you where you go to get it done right the first time. All that and more coming up now. Hello, everybody. My name is Adam Gordon, edutainer here at IT Pro TV, coming at you with a fun and exciting episode in our Hey, How Do I Do That in Windows Server series. Remember, you could check us out for our YouTube channel. Definitely want to subscribe to that. You'll be able to find this and all of our other episodes in this ongoing conversation. How do you get all that stuff done in Windows? Well, you check us out, you subscribe, and if you need more in-depth conversations, more training, and indeed just more understanding, come on over to itpro.tv directly and check us out there, where myself and all the other edutainers are spending time creating lots and lots of really cool and engaging content about Windows and about all sorts of other stuff as well. All right, so we're here to talk about how to set up an FTP server on Windows Server 2022. Now, a lot of you may be saying, well, doesn't sound like it's all that complicated, but you know, every time I try, there's a lot of things I gotta think about, there's a lot of options, I'm not sure what I should choose. Well, I'm gonna show you a real simple and easy way to get through all of that. Join me here if you will. We're using Windows Server 2022, remember, running it as a virtual machine. That way we can have the benefit of being able to deploy it, not have to worry about all the infrastructure we need to run it directly. And I've opened up the Server Manager in Server 2022 as I've logged on. Now, if you're not familiar with the Server Manager, not sure how to even get it open, or maybe it's not open on your machine as you get started, and you're looking at a desktop that looks like this, well, it's really simple. You just go down to the Start menu right down here, the lower left, you're gonna click there. We're gonna be able to navigate up to our Windows Server navigation bar. You'll see right here, this bunch of tiles that are pinned. In the upper left-hand corner, the Server Manager tile is gonna always be there. If you click on that, that will bring up the Server Manager. It loads up and starts just like that. Takes a couple of seconds to kind of get itself situated, figure out what services are running, get a general status update on the system. That's what that blue line going across the top is all about. And when these little placards here turn from red to green, telling us that everything is updated, the system is set, we're ready to go, there they go, we could go ahead and we can get started. Now you'll notice over here on the right-hand side, or excuse me, on the left-hand side, in our navigation area, that I've got something that's gonna be of interest to us specifically because we wanna focus on FTP. File Transport Protocol is going to allow us to be able to upload and download files either individually or in bulk through and usually associated with a web service. And we often will set up a website that is going to use the FTP protocol to be able to do that. Well, the reality is that website, those services and those protocols are associated with the web server that Microsoft embeds in their server product called IIS, the Internet Information Server. And IIS in and of itself is a role that can be installed and configured in Windows Server. And it looks like we've already got some of those elements here because it's showing up in our navigation area. But we're not sure if we have FTP already installed or not just by seeing IIS there. And this is important for you to note. We can click on the IIS shortcut, as I'm about to do. And what you'll find is that we see a listing of the IIS server or servers that are running the IIS role. And we can see information about the name of the server, IP address, the fact that it seems to be online and performance counters may or may not be currently running. Seems like we've done some updating and we have a status update on the last time we did that and the fact that Windows is indeed activated. But beyond that, we don't see any indication of the status of FTP. But there is a shortcut that may be of interest to you here. We can right-click anywhere on that blue line that represents the server. And as I do that, I get a pop-up menu that allows me to manage the server. One of the things I can do is add roles or features, which we're gonna need to do in order to establish and configure FTP. And I can do a bunch of other stuff, including managing the server, using PowerShell, and as you could see, a variety of other things. But what I wanna do is launch the Internet Information Services IIS Manager, MMC, the Microsoft Management Console. I wanna establish definitively, before we go in and do this, whether FTP is actually already configured on the server. And the best way to do that is to go ahead and look at the management console if the web services are indeed up and running. If IIS is not there, we know for a fact there's no way FTP is gonna be installed and configured. But since IIS is there, it's worth a few seconds of our time to double check that. So I'm gonna go ahead and open up the IIS manager. We could see we're running IIS Server Services version 10, and that means we're running the latest version based on Server 2022. And we're going to open up over here on the left. I'm going to click on that. There we go. Open up our server, and we'll look at our homepage here, and we're going to see that we don't see anything as we look at the different areas, ASP.NET, IIS, and management. We don't see an area specific to FTP. We would see that if FTP was already installed and configured. We'll notice it will be there after we finish configuring it. And under sites right here, when I come over here and I right click and we choose add website, we would also see an option to add an FTP site. And because we're not seeing either of those things, we know FTP is currently not installed and configured in the web services. So we're going to close that configuration window, close the MMC. We're now going to go ahead and actually install and configure FTP as part of the IIS web services stack. Now, we could do that right from here, as I was suggesting. We can use our add roles and features shortcut, or we can come up here to our manage area, right up here at the upper right-hand corner, and we can click on manage. And when we do that, we have the same shortcut for add roles and features. Winds up in the same place, does the same thing, doesn't matter where we click to begin. All we have to do is click to get started. We have our before you begin screen, really just giving us some overview information about how we can use this wizard. We'll bypass that for now. As a matter of fact, you could actually get rid of that and never have it show up again if you want to skip that page overall and simply check that box off. You won't have to start there. You'll start on this page going forward. We do have the opportunity here with installation type to specify whether we want to do a role-based or feature-based install. That's what we're going to do now to set up FTP. We can also configure remote desktop services, providing remote access and service hosting through this machine so we can serve up content to other users. We can configure that separately if we choose to. We'll accept the default. We then have the option here on the destination server we want to target for this installation to choose the default, which is the server that we are on locally, selected in the server pool box. If there is more than one server available, we would just simply have to know which server to target, select the appropriate one. And if we want to focus on select and or work with a virtual hard disk, configuring it, which would then be used to spin up one or more virtual machines pre-configured with this solution already installed, we could select that virtual hard disk right there. We'd have some additional steps that we'd have to follow to configure it, including providing the path to where that virtual hard disk will be found that we can work with. But we're going to stick with our server and just choose to work on the local machine. We then get to the server roles area. This is an alphabetized list that allows us to access the role or roles we want to install. And by the way, we can install more than one role simultaneously. That's not a problem. Now, down below, it's alphabetized, so all the way at the bottom, third up from the bottom, we see web server IIS in parentheses, and it says there's a certain number of total options available, 43 in this case, of which roughly about half, 19, are currently configured and installed. We see a black square indicating that we've selected one or more of those options, but we don't see a check mark indicating all of them are configured, so we want to differentiate visually as to how that's working. We have a carrot, a little arrow there to the left of the black square that lets us select, opening that area up, moving down, and seeing that we do have some options. And sure enough, the one that is currently not selected, that is white, FTP server, is the one we're here to deal with. We're going to install the FTP server by selecting that box. There may or may not be additional dependencies, management tools, other things we need that are features. We'll be prompted to accept and install those automatically. If you remember when we started, I told you, hey, it's not really that complicated. And one of the biggest objections I get from people about setting up services like this is, you know I can configure, I know I can select, but it's all those additional things that Microsoft or the vendor tells me I need. I never know if I've gotten them all. And I'm always worried I'm going to get it wrong. Well, Microsoft's taking care of that for you. They're going to automate that process, and you're not going to have to worry about it. Let me show you what I mean. We're going to click FTP here. We'll just quickly open that up to see that we do have two items we can choose, the FTP service and FTP extensibility. If we're not sure what each of them are, we can highlight them and read the description over here as necessary. We'll go ahead and we'll choose both. We'll click next. And then if there are any dependencies, any additional features for management or things like that, they would pop up on a screen and we would be told, select these automatically. We're not seeing that. That means we don't have to worry about them in this particular install. We can choose additional features here if we would like. If we don't want to, no problem. We don't have to. Now, remember, we've already installed IIS prior to doing this FTP install, and the management tool for IIS, the IIS management console, is already installed as well. If this was the first time we were configuring all of this, we would be prompted to install some additional features, including those remote management tools that are necessary to enable web services management. So you may get a different outcome depending on where you are as you do your install. All right, we're going to click next. We're going to go ahead. We're going to see that we have our installation and the steps involved teed up so we know what's going to happen. We do have this option to restart the system automatically if necessary. If we choose that, we'll get a prompt here that says, hey, are you sure you want to do that? If you do, we're just going to restart the server when we're ready. We're not going to warn you. We're just going to restart it. Anybody connected, anybody working is going to experience an outage. And that is not okay. We want to make sure we note that and just be aware of that. Plan ahead. In other words, don't inconvenience people. I'll click yes. No big deal. I know for a fact this install doesn't require a restart, so we're not worried about that. But in the real world, it's important to note that in case you have remote users using this server while you're trying to install. We'll click install. Installs can take anywhere from maybe 30 seconds to several minutes, depending on how many services we're configuring, how many options we've chosen, the number of dependent tools and features that may be involved in this configuration. So we might have to be a little patient, that's okay. Our blue progress bar there indicates where we are and how much further we have to go. We're just over halfway there, not too much longer. We're gonna let that finish up. As soon as it does, we're gonna go back in to the IIS manager, the IIS MMC. We're gonna open it up and we're gonna see that FTP has made things look and feel a little different. We're gonna prove, in other words, that FTP is actually configured and installed. We're gonna be on the lookout for that area that's gonna list all the FTP specific management services, as well as the ability to right click and create an FTP site. Looks like we're done. So let's go ahead and let's check that out. We're gonna click close and we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna come over here to tools, because we want to open up the IIS management console. Remember, we can right click and do that right from here, but we can do the same thing by going to tools and we can simply find that the tool is listed there as well. Works the same way. We're going to go ahead, we're going to click that, we're going to open that up. On the surface, looks the same as what we just saw. Let's go ahead, let's open this up. Let's click here, and you'll notice right below ASP.NET, right above IIS, I'm going to zoom in so you could see it. We've got this whole section right here that was just added specific to FTP and the management of the FTP protocol and all of the bells and whistles. So we can tell immediately, visually, hey, something's changed. It's brand new stuff. And of course, we can go in and use any and all those capabilities to start managing, configuring all the aspects of FTP. We also know that we can come down here to sites, as I suggested to you right over here. And when we do that, we can right click and notice we don't just have the ability to add a website now, but also separately an FTP site. So yet another way that we can tell that FTP has indeed been added, configured, and is now ready for us to go ahead and start configuring, setting up, ultimately hosting a website and using the FTP capabilities to upload and download files, either singly or in bulk, within or outside of the organization or both, as circumstances may warrant. So this is how we set up and configure FTP on a Server 2022 server. Doesn't take very long. It's actually pretty straightforward. Hopefully you'll find it to be relatively simple. If you need additional thought processes out there in your organization, hey, how can I host this file service? How can I get this up and running? Well, we've just shown you the beginning, but remember, there's always more to the story. If you want an in-depth conversation around how to set up and configure FTP, and oh, by the way, do so securely, well, you know where to go. ITPro.tv is gonna be the place for you. I'm gonna go get ready for more of those episodes we keep talking about. I got some cool and exciting things coming up that we wanna show you how to do. But until I'm ready to do that, and until you come back and join me, I'm gonna wish you happy servering, and I'll see you soon.